Mr. Jafar is on the other end. He cited that report that there were threats received by certain teachers. Can you elaborate on that? And who do you think was behind those threats on the teachers yesterday?
Yeah. Alam ko, kasabay nung pag-threat sa teachers, no? One of our supporters, Judge Rasalan, who is a very known bold critic, the House of Judge Rasalan was... A grenade was lobbed at the house of Judge Rasalan. Although there were no injuries, still, that incident made a difference. So voters, and there were thousands. We're not talking of hundreds. We're talking of thousands of MILF supporters who flocked inside Cotabato City.
To do what?
Just to observe, according to them. But you see, you're not talking hundreds, you're talking of thousands. And whenever a voter, a Cotabato voter, passes by this flock of MILF supporters, they are shouting and chanting, and so it scared the voters away.
Okay. Now, regarding that particular incident which happened outside the house of the judge, do you think that incident was connected to the plebiscite? Since it happened before that, do you think the intention was to intimidate the judge and other residents who were supposedly opposed to the BOL?
You know, I was talking about social media harassment and intimidation. He was a victim too.
On social media, the judge?
Yes, he was threatened online.
Now, if this were the case, as you claim, how credible would the results be given the incidents that you mentioned?
I beg your pardon?
How credible do you think the results would be as far as Cotabato City is concerned, given the incidents that you cited?
You know, it is a fact that we won in more barangays. We won in more barangays. There were barangays that showed a very low outcome, low turnout of voters. It was because of the intimidation of these MILF supporters. Some people were also mauled, and there were incidents of violence, vote buying, and everything. You know, if you file charges against these people, it will take you years, and nothing will still happen. It's actually a waste of time and money. And I think the best judge here are the people. Were it not for the thousands of MILF supporters inside the city, who intimidated the voters, no would handily win. And even the military and the PNP were helpless.